Let's get started. So we're gonna build this thing. So basically it's a Bitcoin. So not really the Bitcoin. So one Litecoin is $41 right now. Two. One. And we're gonna do Ajax call with PHP. So install XAMPP, self-explanatory. And when you run XAMPP, you're gonna have this little guy on off for 80. So it's localhost. Sweet. And you're gonna navigate to your C drive. T's, you're gonna go to XAMPP, HD docs. And you're gonna open it with your new handy dandy file. Call this YouTube.php. We're gonna open Sublime Text, L, CMD, L. Let's open. Window. All this. So started. Boom. So I'm using Emmet, so have Emmet installed. Do PHP, boom. So first things first, let's create an array called coin, and we're going to have a set of arrays, BTC, USD, Ethereum to USD, and we're going to BTC to USD. Cool. So I'm assuming how arrays work. So we're gonna echo coin 0. The count sign is 0. So we're gonna echo that. It's going to show localhost YouTube. Localhost YouTube. PHP. So we got that displayed. So that's the first array. It's gonna echo that. It's great. All right, let's hold the URL for Ajax request. So the Ajax request is this long string right here. I'm gonna provide it under the video. It's gonna be a very, very long video. Notes. Boom. But we don't want this. We want to concat. So we're concat. So coin. Concat is dot. It's not plus in this, unless you're doing like JavaScript. So 0. Boom. Purchase it. So we're going to do a file get. Hold the JSON this variable, JSON decode. We're passing the file get, so I'm gonna call paste. It's going true. And we're gonna do a var dump. Var dump. JSON. Calling myself. That's our array. So that's going to be the Bitcoin array. So that looks like this. but instead of BTC to USD. So it's not like that. Let's make this bigger. Draw blind. Okay. If you hear background noise, it's my sister. She's married, so they're getting ideas. I'm gonna do next. I got var dumped. So I var dumped. That's fine. Response. Let's build something good. Let's leave that here. So we're gonna do a style. So we're gonna do container size 1m. Boom. Next to add borders. With this 175 pixels. 10x40 pixels. We're gonna create borders for the, if you remember, the two pieces, so let's create two. So how about that? Container, save, H1, BTC to USD converter. So, create her call. Current price of Bitcoin. So, our current is Bitcoin. Boom. Just have this now. So, she questioned. And question. Because we're creating a template. It's a giant template name string. Let's do an echo. Echo my name. Echo my name right there. Echo. Echo's print. Alright, what am I gonna do next? I was gonna print the price, right? So, let's leave it alone. Now we want to echo, so we're going to back up. So we have that JSON, access the var dump. This is the first array, so that's a var dump, or access that. So we're going to copy and paste here, var dump. So we're going to get that, save, see what shows. Oh no. Shoot. Oh no no. Oh, semicolon. I guess I'm expecting T. Bug. Oh, I need something. So. Let's do last. Oh, cuz something shoot out rest of the, well, the access that array or the shoes on. So we're gonna do last four. Let's do last and hopefully this prints. Let's print pissed off. Still there. Nine. Oh, should I? Oh, this is. Oh. Oh, the variable. You can't access array without naming the variable. Silly me. Now I guess to show that. There we go. Now I'll show that. There we go. To the array. Line 29. So, yeah. Let's print out last. Boom, we have the Bitcoin price now. Amazing. Current price of Bitcoin is 22.41. That's good. Cool. Alright, let's build the converter. Alright. Got that in there. So let's create two inputs. Text ID is going to be BTC. We're going to do on change. On change is like when you type. We'll leave these blank. So we're going to have two functions in here. BTC. Maybe I should copy BTC. USD. Let's use USD. Let's call this USD. And let's create our JavaScript. Oh, this makes it load quicker. This async defer part, but I don't need this part. We're just writing the script. Then IntelliSense is awesome. All right, cool. So let's create a variable to store the So let's call it const BTC equals to. We're really dirty. Echo. Right here. Just copy and paste this entire string and store it. Store string. Boom. And that string. Strings are letters. String. Alright. Let's name the first function BTC. Let's name the second function USD. Cool. Oh, I need a semicolon. Call. Semicolon. Save. This is a really, really dirty way. Other ways to use, but it's gonna be really quick. So we have that. Now we're gonna create a function. Let's call it BTC. I'm gonna use ES5. I just realized it's not whatchamacallit, it's not Node.js, so I can't use the new fancy ES6 stuff, so bars. Mount equals document get element by ID calls BTC. Dot value, so it's gonna grab the value from here, from the ID, that grabs that. Got it, good. Var BTC calc equals to amount times BTC, let's do some math, the var BTC calc to so restore it, you can see calc dot to fixed two decimal places and element by ID, cost of USD, value equals to BTC calc. Oh, that is made. But let's do the polar opposite. So function USD. USD equals to document get ID USD dot value grabbed it var USD calc equals to USD divided by BTC var USD calc equals to USD calc dot to fixed. Pick decimal places, document, the element by ID, BTC dot value equals to USD. Table somewhere? Grabs a value document 1 second.